just her song and her vibe, totally. Maybe like an ENFJ. I don't know, but she's totally, I love her. She's one of my top people that I jam to, and I always have. Man, they're building this place up so much. San Antonio, crazy. Downtown like the plague, unless I already know, and so I'm, okay, we got it, we're okay, that was a close one, yeah, but I'm familiar with, like, where the courthouse is and all that, so, like, that's, I'm good on that. It's not funny, but because of, like, you know, I had to put a protective order in and all that, so, and then I got served with divorce papers in response to that, so it's been, weird, but I've had to go down there quite a bit in the last year. Also, like, the victims advocacy places and stuff, in West.
Hold on.
Sorry. Okay, now we're back on track. So yeah, anyway, I've been down there quite a bit. And, so I know that area. I know, like, the Pearl area downtown, and it was a zoo. Like, if there's a good destination, I'm in the kind of immediate surrounding area, I'm good. I can navigate that. But if it's just like, oh yeah, let's go hang out downtown, I'm like, no, let's not, like, anxiety, because some of the roads downtown, I don't know if this is like this in all big cities, but they have a ton of, like, one-way streets, and it's like, man, if you could just turn right here, then you'd be right near your destination, but you can't turn that way. You have to go, like, way around, and it's confusing. But the good thing is, in San Antonio, all the parking meters for disabled vets and stuff is free. And, like, it's, so that's cool. Like, you can street park, usually, it's a street park, though, at, like, the meters and stuff. And then a lot of the, parking, like, at the courts and stuff, it's legit, like, you just park, and if you've got DV plates, like, they just basically leave your car alone. They don't tag it or anything, so that's awesome. I'm like a crazy woman driver right now.
Crazy woman driver!
Okay, so I'm going, oh god, here we go. 35 south, towards Laredo. Okay. Yeah, but do I go 35 south? That's where I went last time. South Laredo. No, that's not where I went last time. Okay, we're good. I'm slated to get there 5 minutes early. And so, I left super early, and I love, that's why I left early. Early. My brother came over, he's awesome. I think he's an, IN something J. But yeah, no, he's cool. I feel kind of bad because he's like, you know, the single guy who is used to his own environment. And then I try not to ask him to babysit too often. But he's like my core support right now. And I try not to ask him, not because I don't trust him. I trust him implicitly. But it's because I've got four kids. And they all, like, love him. And so they're like, ah, I just, like, bombard him, and I'm always like, like, I can handle it to a point, because, like, I've been a single parent with them all through crazy times in the last year. Well, I've always been, like, a single parent, let's not kid ourselves, but, especially this last year, excuse me, and so, I can escape, you know, a little bit here and there, but with him, I'm like, you're probably, like, strung out, like, on stress by the time I, like, come back, so I try to reserve those times for, like, emergencies or, like, serious stuff, like, my tooth needs to get seen. But I'm glad that I could leave early enough to get breakfast. That was nice. Okay, so it looks like I'm going to be turning right. Hopefully the camera angle's good. I don't even know if this is recording, to be honest with you. I'll be kind of annoyed. But then I'll be like, meh, there's nothing I could have done about it anyway. I just got this camera online for the car because I was like, hey, it's really hard for me to vlog normally. Like, I can, but it's going to be a lot more disjointed and stuff because of just all the stuff that I have to do around the house and the kids on a daily basis. I just missed my street. My depth perception was off. Now I gotta go all the way down here. Oh my goodness. Can I just go down one of these little streets? No, because it's probably like some crazy like one-way street. Hey, it's Starbucks. It's funny. Anyway. So, I was like, you know what? And the kids say like the funniest stuff. When, like, they say funny stuff all the time, but, when we're, like, in the car and doing stuff, they can say some funny things, and so I like to capture that. I'm getting nervous about the dentist now. So, I've called them a couple times and been like, yo, y'all left a hole in my tooth. Can I please come in and get seen? Obviously, like, I was a lot nicer than that. But then now it's been bothering me. Like, it's super sensitive. And so I'm like, okay, from a medical standpoint, that's not good. Like, you don't want an infected tooth because it can leak into your bloodstream and cause septicemia. Which is like an infection in your bloodstream, and if you don't get that taken care of, like, you could die. And I'm like, I'm not looking to even get a fever nowadays, because if you show up with a fever, you're just like, they're going to be jamming all kinds of test tubes in your nose and trying to get you for coronavirus, and I can't be dealing with that drama, so I need to take care of this. So I call them, and I'm like, yo, this is kind of bad. I need to get seen. And they're like, sorry, it's not that big of a deal. And I'm like, yeah, it kind of is. So then I had to pull out my, like, gusto and be like, yo, like, because they were like, I don't know if they're going to see you. And I was like, well, I need to at least get evaluated. And they're like, well, I don't know if they're going to. And I was like, well, I came in for a filling and y'all didn't do it right. That's, like, malpractice. So I threw the legal book at him and was basically, like, on the down low, like, okay, or I could sue you for malpractice. Like, I didn't say that because it's too much work to do that kind of crap anyways. And he was just like, well, I don't know. I'll call him and leave a message. And so I'm like, there you go, thanks. So they left a message, and so I don't know. They might be like, this lady is a jerk, and that's also making me nervous because, I mean, I'm not trying to, like, bite the hand that feeds me, you know what I mean? Or rather, like, I don't want to upset the hands that are going to be, like, all up in my mouth, that making decisions of, like, sensitive nature. But it is what it is, you know? I decided to make the decisions I made, and now I'm just trusting God to help me out. Help me, Rhonda. Help me, Rhonda. Help me, Rhonda. Yes, get her out of my heart. I'm nervous. I'm gonna be so tired after this because my anxiety and, like, talking and everything. It's good, though. This part is good, because I don't ever vlog in the car, and I feel kind of like it's therapy. And I'm, like, doing the whole, like, INFP stare. I don't know if you can see. Well, that's bright. I'm just, like, do you guys ever have, like, as INFPs, do you guys ever have, like, I find that I'm always, my brain is always grabbing a song or a movie line from somewhere, some reference. And it's always at, like, well, it's at inappropriate times, too, but it's also at, fun, like, relatable times. Like, right now, in my head, I have the whole, Disney Hercules where he's like, I can go the distance, I don't care how far, if I must be strong. Anyway. And that's funny, but now I'm, like, freaking terrified. I'm terrified. Help me. Oh, so I'm trying to be considerate and not park in the, like, dock, oh, in the handicap, even though I can. And so I keep driving, and then I'm going to park in the next one. It's like, doctor, for the doctor. And I'm like, are you serious right now? Fine. Oh, shoot, I forgot I have to have a mask. Stupid. Anyway, I'll see you guys later. I'm scared. Better take my camera in so, like, somebody doesn't, like, feel it. I know that sounds messed up, but, like... Here we go. Did it turn off?